Under the association, Nyakatonzi Cooperative Union, located in Kamulikwizi Cell, Nyamwamba Division of Kasese Municipality, cotton farmers have reported poor yields in cotton. Authorities are concerned that the poor performance of one of the country's major cash crops will cripple their standards of living.
Cotton seeds for planting from Serere, but some good years we have been getting seeds from Zimbabwe, the yield was not good. It would be good for 2 years, then after 2 years, the yield becomes the worst, like this year and last year. And from an acre, we would get only 200 kilograms. When we use it, we get 1,000 kilograms, 800 kilograms.
According to Adrian Katwete JK, the CDO Western Region Coordinator, the seeds that were given to farmers were of poor quality, and this has affected the yields.
Also found out that our seed is getting a bit tired and may not yield as well. You know, seed after planting and replanting, supposedly it does not give very good yields. Yields keep deteriorating, and we have been planting this seed for some time, but we already found out that problem, and we are working with the researchers at Serere. We are already now multiplying. We got seed, foundation seed from Serere. We are now multiplying it at the prison farms of Rukoki and Mbuku, and this season much of the region, more than half of the region will receive good, very high yielding variety.
He further attributed the poor yields to inadequate rainfall that was experienced shortly after the planting season.
I think they are partly right, but we attribute the reason to late planting. We received rains late, mid-September, yet normally we start planting end of July. So the late planting always in agronomy, when you plant late, chances that your yields will be affected. Now the other issue is the germination also was not good, because even when the rains came, they were not enough. Farmers planted, but the germination was not good. You find the plant population, because if the germination is, and you don't get enough plant population, then it affects yields. For example, if you are supposed to have like 12,000 plants in a garden, and now you have only 9,000, that itself affects yield at planting.
Lieutenant Joe Walusimbi, the resident district commissioner, advised the cotton farmers to remain united so as to benefit from government projects. Farmers were also urged to grow cotton on a large scale if they want to realize ample profits.
They should remain cooperative, because government will need, or in need of people who are together, like these cooperative societies, like the SACOs and others. So if they are together, they can easily get a loan. All government can support them through their cooperatives. So that's why I say people should remain united, and this Nyakatonzi should remain as it is. It is a rich society. So they should work together.
During the function, new officers at Nyakatonzi Cooperative Union were sworn in, and this was spearheaded by Lieutenant Joe Walusimbi, the Kasese RDC. Story compiled by Samuel Amanyire for the news.
Yeah.